everybody, Milo here along with Henry, and we have a really cool YouTube video for you today about your belt buckle.
Oh yeah. Anthony Kim, back in the day, we need one of those big ones, right?
Yeah. So, what's the video today? What are we talking about, Henry?
So we're going to talk about how, I mean, we're going to talk about the belt buckle, but how the belt buckle, you want it to get pointed down in transition and then around through impact versus up and out, right?
Yes.
Because this is a move we see all the time. And really one of the biggest issues we see amongst population of golfers, and this is something I struggle with sometimes too, is sort of that early extension, thrust, we call it goat humping, whatever you want to call it, but basically that belt buckle starts pointing out.
So if I had a laser beam pointing straight out of my belt here, as I turn to the top of my backswing, you can see the direction that would be aimed. Now as we change directions, what we see with most golfers is this starts to go more up.
Oh yeah.
What do we see with those that play on tour or really high level players generally?
Well, we see it work more level or slightly even down and pointed back at the ball in transition.
Yeah, so for most of the really top level ball strikers, as they change direction, you can see how that aimed more down.
Yeah.
So that's what we're talking about today. We're trying to get that belt buckle in transition to feel like it aims more down as it starts to go around.
Now I'm going to make an assumption here that most of our viewers have probably seen that old Tiger Woods clip with Butch Harmon talking about this ole move, right?
Yes.
Similar, spinning out a little bit and getting, but it's also getting early extended, tilted.
Yeah, so that's a question I get a lot. What is a spin out? Because
yep.
People hear me talk about how we want to get rotation started early. What's the difference in rotation started early and a spin out? Well, a spin out would be me firing my hips up and forward like that, where this belt buckle immediately starts to go up. Then what happens? The club falls behind us, and now we've got to go catch it up with our hands and
Olé.
Flick it. Olé. Yep. Yeah. You see it a lot with little kids. So what we're trying to get is kind of the opposite there. It's not that we're not turning. My belt buckle is definitely rotating, but it's not firing in that way.
Right. So a lot of you at home, the first move in transition is sort of, you're trying to get in the ground, but really what's going on is you're pushing up out of the ground early, right?
Mm-hmm.
Instead of sort of falling into the ground, calling this the squat, a lot of people say, right? And get this belt buckle pointed back at the ball.
Yeah, so what's really happened is I call it reflexing into the ground. So at address, we're kind of in a flexed position, knees flexed, our body's kind of rounded off, flexed. As we swing back, our spines extend. Now we've got to go back into flexion.
Mm-hmm.
That's how we create force into the ground.
Okay.
Okay?
Very cool. So what would be a practice we can do to get our viewers at home feeling that?
Something that I like to use, alignment sticks. So you can just slide that through your belt, Henry. Okay, we got it. Now slide it almost all the way through so it's mostly on this side. Okay? Now, make a backswing for us. Now, as you change directions, the goal is to get this tip to look like it goes down and around. Yeah, like that. We don't want the tip show us the wrong way, so if you did the ole, fire your hips.
Well, I don't want to stab you, Milo.
Well, you can't reach me here. So you can see the stick immediately starts going up before it starts going, and it never really goes around.
Right.
So when you fire your hips up and forward, they don't open very well. They don't get nearly as open. So down and around helps you get them open. There you go. So show us from down the line what that looks like.
You want the bad one?
See the bad one? It goes up in front of you. Now show us the good one. There we go. So see how that goes around?
Right. So you can still rotate with that first move, and that would be more your spin out. So it'd be kind of like that, but this is still moving back up and out.
Yes.
Right.
And that's what causes you to get what some would coin stuck.
Yeah.
Well, there's your problem.
So, and you don't really believe in let's get the club more in front of us necessarily. Let's just figure out how to work better into the ground and pivot correctly.
Yeah, I'm not really a fan of trying to make your arms do something faster.
Right.
I'm a fan of trying to get your body to move a little bit better.
Right.
Not that there aren't multiple ways to fix things, but I think that the more dynamic way is like this. This is how the good movers move.
So I'm gonna, can I hit one slow with this thing?
Yeah.
Just to feel it?
For sure.
So, and you could also put a stick back here. You've done this before, a stick click drill where it clicks that other stick.
Yeah, so with players who struggle to get their bodies to start unwinding and opening up, I'll put another stick there where it would be ideally at impact and have you try to click the sticks before you hit the ball. But the idea here is we're just getting into the ground, getting our belt buckle to move down and around in transition. Because if we do that, we're not spinning out, we're putting max force into the ground, and we're gonna be way efficient.
So if you guys have some laser beams at home, attach that to the belt buckle and you can make a nice little path with your belt buckle. Make sure you don't hit the wall or the ceiling with it, okay? Don't blind your kids back at home. So thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and we'll see you next time.